into the quicksands of the big city. I have never known a father's care or a blessing of a happy home. Aww. So now you see.
So now I see you.
Bereft of all support, a prey to my basic instincts.
Yes. Like a derelict in high school, if they want. Now tell me, derelict, which district did you recite that fair historian?
What do you mean, Mr. Peachum?
Will I take you recite public?
This way, Mr. Peachum. Yesterday, there I was, standing on the corner, quiet and miserable, holding up my hat. No suspicion of anything nasty.
Highland Street! Yes, yes! Who the bastard had his sample yesterday?
Very worst.
Number 20, that's what she
Harry Beecham, who has followed me and my love in order to share my life with me.
All over London, they'll be saying this is the most daring job you've ever pulled, Matt.
But you can't be meaning to have our wedding here. Why, it's a common stable.
Dear child, everything shall be done as you wish.
That'll be furniture. There's a shit.
New Lil. How does she spell that one?
Yes, that's what you say.
How does she spell that one?
All through the night. Through the night and to do, and you wonder, who's that person that lives up there?
And you see me stepping out in the morning, looking nice, with a ribbon in my hair.
And the
Oh,
heart beating, my beloved.
I feel it, beloved. Where you go, there too shall I be.
Wherever you go, I shall be with you.
Love and joy.
Dear Mama, you can spare yourself a trip. Mac will go to the Old Bailey of his own accord sooner than meet with any of those ladies. And if he was to go to the Old Bailey, Brown would be very happy to see him because you see, Papa, the Sheriff was very happy at my wedding.
And what's the gentleman's name?
Tiger Brown. But you probably know him as Tiger Brown because anybody who has reason to fear him knows him as Tiger Brown. But my husband, you see, knows him as Jackie because to him, he's just dear old Jackie, their boyhood friends.
So they're friends, are they? Sheriff and public enemy number one!
Every time they drank a cocktail together, they stroke each other's cheeks and said, if you'll have the same again, I'll have the same again. And every time one of them left the room, the other's eyes grew moist. And they said, wherever you go, I shall be with you. There's nothing on record against Mac at Scotland Yard.
Between Tuesday evening and Thursday morning,
He takes what he pleases.
Who's that the knife? Come on, we're going to the Sheriff of London.
I, Papa, shall be delighted to shake hands with the Sheriff again.
You know, I've got better things to do than pack.
No, we mustn't now. I'm so frightened. All they did was talk about hanging.
I don't like it when you read, Polly. There's nothing on record against me at Scotland Yard.
Perhaps it wasn't yesterday, but suddenly today there's an awful lot.
You're a dreadful man, Mac. In Winchester, you seduced two sisters under the age of consent.
But they told me they were over 20. What did Brown say?
He caught up with me in the corridor, so there's nothing he can do for you now. Hey, Mac.
Right. I've got to go away. You're off on the business.
Don't talk about business now, Mac. I can't bear it. Kiss your poor Polly again and swear we're going.
Don't stop on that. I'm not in the mood right now. So, Drew Walter. He's an unreliable sod. Sell stuff on the side. Give him 3 weeks grace, then get rid of him. Just turn him into Brown.
Just turn him into Brown. Will you be faithful to me, Mac?
Of course I'll be faithful. I'll do as I'm done by. Even though I love you, it's just I'll see further ahead than you.
Hey, Mac, I'm so grateful to you. Worrying about me when they're after you like bloodhounds.
You and Carol send these profits to Jack Paul's banking house in Manchester. Between ourselves, it's only a matter of time before I go to the banking altogether. It's safer and it's more profitable. Within 2 weeks, at the most of the money will be taken out of business. And off you go to Brown and give him the list to the police. Within 2 weeks, all the human scum will be safe in the cells of the Old Bailey.
Why, Mac? How can you look them in the eye when they're as good as hands? How can you shake hands with them?
With who? Matt and me? Bob the saw, cook-fingered Jake, those jailbirds. It's a pleasure to see you, gentlemen.
Good evening, gentlemen.
I've got coronation program.
leave. And nobody knows when I shall return.
Don't tear the heart out of my body. Stay with me and let us be happy.
For I must tear my own heart out of my body. And nobody knows when I shall return. I'll take my black stallion from Solnax's stable. For you know it, I'm on the other side. I hate you.
Why, Mac? Last night I had a dream. I was looking out of my window and heard laughter in the street. I saw our moon, and it was all thin like a worn-down penny. Don't forget me, Mac, in Strange City.
Come on. Kiss me, Polly. For love will endure, will not endure, regardless of where we are.
Goodbye, Mac. Nice while it lasted, but now it's over. Tear out my heart, and goodbye to your lover. What use is grieving when the mother who bore you knew it all before you?
Shall we see him though if the constables are after him?
Even with all London at his heels, MacKeith is not the one to give up his habits.
I got the bread.
and now possible, escort the gentleman to his new home. Ladies, if you wish to find him, you will barely find him in. From now on, his new address will be your lady.
Wake up, Jake! Something has happened!
Where's Mac?
The Rosses were here!
Good God! And me, just reading. Well, I never.
If only my men don't catch him. Let's hope to God he's riding up here on Highgate Heath, thinking of his jacket. But he's so fearless, like all great men. If they bring him in now, he looks at me with his face and friendly eyes and won't be able to bear it. Thank God, anyway, the moon is shining. If he's riding across the heath, he won't stray far from the path. What's that? Good God, they're bringing him in.
Down the spine. It worked. I looked at him and he wept. Jade goes around telling everyone that I married her, I'm ready, Lucy, to give you satisfaction. If you think there is any in marriage, what can a man of honour say more? He can say nothing more.
Oh, Matt, I only want to become an honest woman.
If you think marriage with me will, all right. What can a man of honour say more? He can say nothing more.
Where is my dear husband? Hey, Mac, there you are. Why did you turn away from me? It's your Polly. It's your wife. Oh, the miserable villain. Why did you ride across Highgate Heath? I will stay with you till death do us part. You know that. Not one kind word, Mac. Not one kind look.
Oh, the slut.
What does this mean, Mac? Who on earth is this? You might as well tell her who I am. Aren't I your wife? Haven't I done everything for you? Do you have two wives? You monster. Say something, Mac. Tell her. Aren't I your wife? You even put me in charge of the gangs and I've done it all the way we had arranged. And Jake wants me to tell you that he...
If you two would kindly shut your traps for 1 minute, I'll explain everything.
No, I won't shut my trap. I can't bear it. It's more than flesh and blood can stand.
Naturally, the wife...
The wife! The wife is entitled to some more privilege, or at least appearance of it. All this fuss and bother will drive the poor man mad.
Fuss and bother?
That's a good word.
What have you dragged in now?
This messy little tart.
So this is your great conquest, your rose of old Soho.
Just a second. I have to do something very quite important.
corner. It won't be easy for us to hide. As soon as they stop looking for me, I'll send for you post haste.
What can I do to help?
Bring me my cane.
Mankind alive, the fact that millions are daily tortured.
the lady in money, I hope. Now tell me, lady, is Mr. McKeith in jail or isn't he?
Don't talk to me about Mr. McKeith. And if our friend Suki Tawdry isn't here with us now, it's because he went on from me to her to console her too.
Suki Tawdry.
So now you know, you're not fit enough to blacken that gentleman's boots. You miss
door for my savings account right away.
Prima! 5 o'clock in the morning?
Can you manage £400?
But what about us? That's all there is.
Who's been hanged? You or me, man?
Who was laying around sleeping torture instead of clearing out? Yeah. Hey! Who was laying around sleeping torture? Us? Or you?
Oh, shut the trap! Us and me lying somewhere along with that slut!
Don't shout at me, I won't have it!
Oh, I'm not shouting, it's just I'm being hanged and...
Mr. Brown would like to know what you'll have for your...
I'm done, by the way! Will you or won't you? Asparagus!
Stop shouting! I won't allow it!
Matthew, if that's how it is, we'll just have to do it. Just have to do it, I guess.
If you're not here by 5 to 6, you'll never see me again! You'll never see me again!
They're gone! Well, how about it?
£400! I've got to speak to Brown!
Got the sir, Constable! Yes! Let's have the right one!
Right. Set the thing up in 10 minutes!
But that's not enough time!
Well, it's got to be enough time!
Oh, what shambles!
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 Shambles! Oh. We can't possibly let you in! You're only number 16! Wait!
Number 16, what do you mean? I am his wife, I need to see him.
5 minutes then.
5 minutes? That's perfectly ridiculous. Where is he?
Why? Can't you see him?
Oh yes, of course. Thank you.
Polly.
Here I am, Mackie.
What's going to become of you? What are you going to do?
Don't worry about me.
Right, okay, thanks. Thanks, everybody. Thank you.
and I, Tom, Tom, Greg, then Matt and I today. Did a great job, round of applause. Thank you. We decided that because he's done such a great job this evening, as Matt and I, Tom Gray, yeah, that was great, we decided to let him off. So we're not going to hang him, and I'm disappointed. And on top of that, because he did do such a good job, we decided actually to knight him. Give him that, our lord, like sir, so he's now going to be, so those people at school who know him, obviously. He's now calling him Sir Tom Gray, so round of applause for Sir Tom Gray. On top of that, his wife, which one is his wife? Polly, we'll say Polly. Polly's George and I, again another great student. Round of applause for Polly, because obviously you're now married to Tom Gray, that is. We decided that you're going to have all the benefits of being his wife, which is great. It does mean, however, everybody else, that in future, lessons, rehearsals and stuff like that, Tom's going to have to be in charge. So you have to deal with it like that. I think that's kind of it, isn't it? Sorry to interrupt. Very funny. I'll let you get back on. Tom and George are in lesson class. Thank you.
Reprieved. I was most sure of it. And the clouds may be clearing, but it's just despairing.
Reprieve. My dearest McKeith is reprieved. I'm so happy.
So it all turned out nicely in the end. How nice and easy everything would have been if you just wrecking the saviours on horseback.
Now, if you could all please stand in your places to join us for this hymn.
What keeps mankind alive?